Originally conceived as the final set piece for Prometheus, Elizabeth Shaw and David were to be pursued by the newly birthed Deacon alien as they raced towards the second Juggernaut in LV-223. The sequence would have likely been informed by John's space work on the first draft of Prometheus, where Shaw must kill the space jockey-born alien known as the Ultramorph. Various images of this sequence can be found on the Prometheus Collector's Edition Blu-ray set, which provides some context to this scene, as unfortunately it was never filmed. The Deacon can be seen traversing the landscape as it hunts Shaw. The imagery was quite amazing and it really gave a scope to the planet that wasn't seen in the film. It's a shame this was left out as it would have also provided a reason for the Deacon teaser at the end, since it's likely this creature won't return. The Deacon was an interesting concept and personally I would have liked to see it featured more heavily. It was more so a distant relative to the Xenomorph rather than the first evolution of the biomechanical alien that we know. If you guys are interested in knowing what happened to the Deacon after Prometheus, be sure to read the Fire and Stone comic series as it does provide the fate of the creature. Are you upset that we didn't get more screen time with the Deacon? I personally think that this sequence would have amped up the finale to Prometheus and really gave us some type of Xenomorph action or some sort of alien attack sequence that I think a lot of people were sort of hoping for rather than just Shaw's final fight with the engineer that was very heavily edited down. That's another sequence that was sort of left on the cutting room floor, so to speak, that was much different in the original incarnation of the actual storyline. I really do like the design of the Deacon. I think a lot of people don't like it because it's sort of goofy looking to them or they don't understand the name of it, but I think it was an interesting creature that was very much so different. Would have preferred seeing the Ultramorph actually brought to film because it is something that's part of the larger alien canon, and I think that just would have been more fitting for this movie rather than creating a new creature, which is the Deacon, that, like I mentioned, will probably never be seen again on film. With that being said though, would you guys like to see this creature return in a future film, or possibly other extended media? Leave your thoughts down below. If you're new to the channel and you like this video, subscribe for more content like this. We cover all the latest news, theories, character explanations, and trailer breakdowns for everything in the Alien and Predator universe. We've also got a podcast called AVP Underworld in which I collaborate with fellow alien YouTubers, and we provide long-form discussions on certain topics. Thank you guys again for watching. My name is Nick, and I'll catch you next time.